I have 10 time to reflect on my decisions and the circumstances that led to my incarceration. I've learned a great deal about myself. I have worked to uplift and counsel my peers. I have maintained open lines of communication with my family through phone calls, letters, and visits. I have remained positive through this experience, grounded in my faith and encouraged by my supporters. I believe laws should be passed to abolish death by incarceration sentences because it implies that people are not capable of change. It diminishes our relationship with family. When I was arrested, my four children were caught. Now they're in their 50s, with children and grandchildren of their own. I have great grandchildren I've never seen. Death by incarceration sentences can condemn individuals for life based on one mistake, one exercise, and poor judgment. One horrible day that sealed their fate, no matter how many certificates and degrees they earned. Death by make us strangers to our families, no matter how hard we try to stay in touch. These sentences provide no relief to reform and justice. The justice system that deters crime to rehabilitate violent individuals and prevent subsequent offenses, but there has to be some room for mercy. When someone violates traffic rules and receives a citation, the American justice system values lives, some lives, more than others. Police officers are held in such high esteem that their deaths nearly always result in a death by incarceration sentence. Why do manslaughter, self-defense, and third-degree murder fall out of consideration when the victim is wearing a blue uniform? Yet, officers who kill are put on death duty and rarely prosecuted. The whole world rioted for justice for George Floyd, and their children still avoided a death by incarceration sentence with his blatant record of police misconduct. You should have put an oath to protect the third. He will have a chance to be paroled, even though he knelt on a handcuffed man's neck for over 8 minutes. Statistics show that people of color serving death by incarceration sentences far outnumber their white counterparts in similar crimes. These discriminatory sentences that people have gone on for far too long. No one deserves to die in prison who has made the effort to change for the better. I would implore the members of the United Nations to imagine becoming a shadow, a memory while still alive. I would ask them to imagine seeing an empty space. In every family photo, where they should have been. I would ask them how many photo albums are enough. I have been missing from family celebrations for over 50 years. I have paid my debt to society with interest, and I want nothing more than to reunite with my loved ones. Granted freedom, I would become an advocate for other women serving life sentences and fight to eliminate death by incarceration sentences. I would spend my twilight years with my children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren, hoping to be esteemed members of the United Nations to put a face on my life. So, we're definitely, we're reigniting the fight for the Constitution. We've been talking about it in the past couple of weeks. And we're going to do everything to bring a majority home. So, any support that anyone can want to bring to this fight, your advocacy, or however you can, we need so much. So thank you so much, Melinda, for inviting me here today, and thank you for inviting me to Mama Rose.
It is critical for us to continue the fight for those people that are behind the walls until everybody's free. And like we said, nobody's free until everybody's free.